human clement to immortality, reveal thy power. Show me your power. Show me your strength. That is what I am interested in. Reveal thy power. Lay bare the spirit's force. Then will I give back to thee, Satyavan. If you are able to show me the strength of God residing in you, yes, then I can conceive your wish. I can give you, Satyavan, back. Or, then will I give back to thee, Satyavan. Well, so death is willing to give Satyavan back to Savitri. He has come to this point, but on one condition, that she must possess strength. She must possess strength. Unless the strength is there, he is not willing to give Satyavan back. Now, this is doubly true. It is awfully true also. In a certain sense, it is good that death is affirming this. Unless there is strength here, things cannot remain firm. What is the use of Satyavan here? It is weakness. Because that weakness can get swallowed by the void. What is the use of weakness or strength then? That Satyavan then, if he is going to live under the weak condition, it will get automatically swallowed by the void and your effort will be vain. So show me your strength. So in a certain sense, therefore, death is kind of helping Savitri also to form up her strength here, which can stand against the power of the all-swallowing void. And therefore he says, reveal the power, lay bare the spirit's force. It is not only condition, it is also a necessity. Unless the power is there, the strength is there, things cannot happen here. It is a necessity. And death is kind of promoting that through Savitri. He is promoting that through Savitri. So basically, he has practically granted a boon to Savitri. Yes, you can take Satyavan back. But show me your strength. That is the condition he has put. And it is a part of a greater wisdom that is demanding that Savitri should reveal to him in the form of her strength, not of knowledge, of love, or beauty. All right, they are all there. But what demand, what matters is strength, power. Then will I give back to thee, Satyavan. Or, if the mighty mother is with thee, show me her face, that I may worship her. So, he has given an alternative. I don't know whether he had the strength with you or not. If he had the strength, no problem, you can take Satyavan back and everything will be safe. If you don't have the strength, but if you are the mighty mother herself incarnate here in front of me, showing her form, I am not able to see that form of that mighty mother behind you. Reveal to me that form. Then I will concede your wish. You have to have strength, or you have to show that behind you is standing the mighty mother. Then will I give back to thee, Satyavan, or if the mighty mother is with thee, show me her face that I may worship her. Actually, the moment this is granted, the moment Savitri is in a position to show that form, then automatically, at once, the boon gets fulfilled that Satyavan has to go back. because what counts for the safety of Satyavan in his mortal creation is strength. And that strength is assured either in the wake of Savitri or the Mighty Mother herself standing behind her. Or the Mighty Mother is with thee, show me her face that I may worship her. Let deathless eyes look into the eyes of death. Into my eyes, let the deathless eyes of that Mighty Mother look into me. Now, in that sense, when the Mighty Mother can look into the eyes of death, it means that there is no more death. Death cannot stand there anymore. There is no more death. In other words, death is in that position, in that condition, willing to disappear. If she is going to look into his eyes, he is no more death in that form as a denier. In fact, when the Mighty Mother looks into the eyes of this death, the one who is standing behind him will be the true death, the Supreme Himself who had taken the form of death for a certain purpose. It is the Supreme Himself who will reveal that it is behind his death he is standing. So that is possible if the Mighty Mother can look into his eyes. That gaze of hers has a power to transform him. Let deathless eyes look into the eyes of death, and imperishable force touching brute things transform us death into immortal life. It is that gaze the Mighty Mother can transform us life into life divine. That is the possibility. I am about there then. So what happens then? Automatically, in the sequel, there is the life divine. Transform us death into immortal life, then can thy death return to thee and live. He can return back to you and he can live with you. That is a possibility now is spoken on. In fact, he did not grant that boon. It is bound to happen. If the Mighty Mother is going to look into his eyes, this is going to follow automatically. Then can thy death return to thee and live. The prostrate earth perhaps shall lift her gaze and feel near her the secret body of God. This earth lying down, mute, flat here, it is she who will rise, and even the body will experience God. Even the material creation here will see the presence of God himself directly. And feel near her the secret body of God, the secret body, the divine body in the human creation, in the mortal creation. That is what will happen. And love and joy overtake fleeing time. Once that divine body is formed, then it will be the reign of love and joy forever. And that is the fulfillment. So death knows that this is bound to happen. He also knows that this can happen only if the Mighty Mother can look into his eyes. In fact, we might say that as if death was waiting for this moment that Savitri should reveal the full form which is there behind her, which is there in her. The Mighty Mother seated in her. Because he knows that it is the Mighty Mother. When she looks into his eyes, he will be transformed. He was waiting for that moment to get transformed. And in a certain sense, therefore, he is happy that that moment has arrived. And he says that, well, this can happen in the natural sequel. There will be life divine, there will be joy, there will be love, there will be beauty, there will be happiness. All those things will follow in the course of time without any difficulty at all. So, although it looks conditional surrender, It is at the same time the admission of the necessity of denial in the entire process. The purpose of the denial is that you have to have really sufficiently powerful personality to stand against the power of the all-swallowing void, shunya. It can totally absorb you and things can get dissolved. If you are not in a position to oppose that power of the void, then the creation will disappear. If that is not to happen, you have to have strength, power. And that is what is demanding from Savitri. Show me your strength. And of course, Savitri is going to reveal who she is. The Divine Mother, the Mighty Mother herself, is going to reveal her full form in Savitri. And death then retreats.